Good afternoon, everyone. Today we'll discuss about context-free grammar and Grayback normal form. Also, we'll learn how to convert context-free grammar to Grayback normal form. So let's proceed. Okay, so context-free grammar consists of a finite set of grammar rules, which is a quadruple, consists of N, T, P and S, where N is the set of non-terminal symbols, T is the set of terminals where N intersection T equals null, that is, they are a disjoint set. P is the set of production rules, which is defined as N gives N union T closure, that is, the left-hand side of the production rule P does not have any right context or left context. As we all know, start simple. Grayback normal form. A context-free grammar is a Grayback normal form if the productions are in the following forms. A gives B. A gives B, D1, D2, D3 goes on to Dn. S equals null set. Where A, D1 to D2, D3, D4 and Dn are all non-terminals and B is a terminal. Okay, so Shivam will tell us how the algorithm works.
Convert a context-free grammar into Grayback normal form, and we follow the following steps. In step 1, we see if start symbol S occurs on some right hand side or RHS, then we create a new start symbol S dash and a new production S dash give S. And in the next step, if we check if there is null production is present or not. If it is present, then we remove it using the null production removal algorithm. And in the next step, in the step 3, we remove the unit production if there is any unit production present using the unit production removal algorithm. And in the fourth step, we check whether the context-free grammar is already in Chomsky normal form or not. If it is not, then we need to convert it to Chomsky normal form. And in Chomsky normal form, right-hand side has one terminal symbol or two non-terminal symbols. Then we proceed to the next step. Step 5, we change the names of non-terminal into some AI in ascending order of ISL, and like A1, A2, A3 up to AN if N is greater than 2. Then we alter the rules. After that, we alter the rules such that non-terminals are in ascending order or not. If that is A, suppose we take I in the left hand side and J on the right hand side, we always check that I should always be less than J. It can never be I equals to J or I is greater than J. Then after that, if any left recursion is present, we remove all the direct and indirect left recursion. After that, by proper substitution of production, we convert the context-free grammar to Grayback normal form. And now I give it to Shantini.
Okay, now we'll discuss some MCQ based questions. Number 1, the Grayback normal form grammar for the language L equals A to the power N, B to the power N plus 1, where N is greater than equals 0, is among the following options. Well, the answer will be C. Now let's see why. A is not an option because from this grammar, we aren't able to generate any string because there is no terminal string present for S. B is also not an option because in this grammar, we are not able to generate any string because there are no terminal strings present in S. For this one, we are able to generate strings like B, A, B, B, A B B B and so on. For option B again, for this we are able to generate string B A B B A A B B B and so on. But this question is asking for GNF, and this grammar is not GNF. Hence, C is the correct option. Moving on with the second question. The format A gives AB refers to which of the following? Chomsky normal form, Grayback normal form, Beckes normal form, or none of the mentioned? Well, the correct option is Grayback normal form. Let's see why. So context-free grammar is a Grayback normal form if the right-hand sides of all the production rules start with a terminal, optionally followed by some variables. Which of the following does not have left recursions? Chomsky normal form, Grayback normal form, Baker-Snell form, or all of the mentioned? Well, the correct option is Grayback normal form. The normal form is of the format A gives AB, where the right-hand side production proceeds to begin with a terminal symbol, thus having no left recursions.
So now we have a problem which states bring the grammar G with B equals to S comma A comma B, and T equals to A comma B, and production P gives S gives A gives A B A or A, B gives B A B or B into Grayback normal form. So our solution is, first we have to simplify the G and check where no useless variable or production is present and no lambda production is present there. When we remove the unit production, because S gives A is unit production, so we remove S gives A. We have to replace A with production of A after checking the transitive closure of unit production, and here only we have one unit dependency, that is A gives B and S gives AB or A by new rule, and we go to the next step, that is transforming G into an equivalent grammar G dash in Chomsky normal form. Then we have to substitute terminals on production with variables that goes by S gives C1, B C1, or A C1, C1 gives A gives C1, B C1, or A C2 gives B gives C2, A C2, or B. Then we now break down the rules, that is S gives C1, D1, or A, D2 gives B, C1, and C1 gives A, and A gives C1, D1, or A, B gives C2, D2, or B, and D2 gives A, C2, and C2 gives B. Then after that, we proceed to the next slide, that we have to transform the G dash into equivalent grammar G dash in the Grayback normal form. So we need to rename the variables in the form of ascending order, that is V1, V2 till Vn in the production P dash. So as per following the rules, we set S equals to V1, A equals to V2, B equals to V3, and C equals to V4, C2 equals to V5, D1 equals to V6, D2 equals to V7. Now we see that V1 gives V4, V6, or A, V6 gives V3, V4, and V4 gives A, and V2 gives V4, V6, or A, V3 gives V5, V7, or B, V7 gives V2, V5, and V5 gives B. Now we move on to the next step, that is we have to order the production. That is, we order the production in the form V1 gives V4, V6, or A, V2 gives V4, V6, or A, V3 gives V5, V7, or B, V4 gives A, and V5 gives B, V6 gives V3, V4, V7 gives V2, V5. And we check whether V of I, that is I is less than G or not. In the first case, there is V1 and V4. So here I is less than G, so this one is perfect. And now we check for V2. V2, that is 2 is less than 4, so I is less than J, and this is also fine. And again, we check for B3 and I. Again, I is less than J, that is 3 is less than 5. So this is also perfectly fine. And V4, it goes to A, which is a terminal variable. So we see that V4 is also perfect, and V5 in the similar way is also perfect. V6 gives V3 and V4. So now we see that V of I is greater than V of J. So this is not possible. And in V7 also, we have V gives to V2 and V5. And again, we see that V of I is greater than J. So for rules of V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 are okay, but we need to modify the V6. So we substitute production of V3 in V6 rule. That is, V6 gives V5, V7, V4 or V4. Again, we see that I is greater than J.
Shivam, where are you exactly?
On the previous slide. Yes, I am in this slide. And then...
Can you continue from here?
Yes, I am continuing. Then we modify V6 rule. V6 goes V3, V4. Substitute production of V3 in V6 rule. And we get V6 goes to V5, V7, V4 or V4. Again, we see that I is greater than J. So this is not possible. So again, we have to substitute production of this V5 in module V6 rule, that V6 gives B, V7, V4 or V4. And now we check I is
Shivam. You are supposed to tell me where you are exactly.
Yes, I am in order of production page. Yes, this one.
So can we do it once more, because I kind of got distracted and I don't know where he is reading exactly.
No, okay. One thing
can we do the problem once again?
Yeah, you can. There you go. No issue.
Hello, sir.
Yes, you can do it. Yes.
Okay, sir. Yes. We'll begin from the problem once again.
Okay.
And Shivam, please tell me when I'm supposed to click on the next slide.
Okay. Now we move on to the problems. Problem of converting CNF to GNF. Now the problem statement is, bring the grammar G with B equals to SAB, B equals to A comma B and production P. And we see that S gives A gives ABA or A, B gives BAB or B into GNF. Now we move on to the solution, and the first step, we have to simplify G and check whether any useless variable of production is there or any lambda production is there. So we remove that. So in this, we see that there is a unit production S gives A. So we remove unit production S gives to A. In this, we replace A with production of A after calculating transitive closure of the unit production. And we see there is only one unit dependency, that is A gives to B. And so we see S gives ABA or new rule. Shantley, please move on to the next slide. And then we see the next step. Next step is, we have to transform G into an equivalent grammar G dash in Chomsky normal form. So we substitute terminals of production with variables in the following way. S gives C1, B C1 or A. C1 gives B. C1 gives A. A gives C1, B C1 or A C2 gives B. And B gives C2, A, C2 or B. Now we break down the rules. So we get S gives C1, D1. Or AD1. D1 gives B, C1 and C1 gives A. And then after that, A gives C1, D1 or A. And after that, B gives C2, D2 or B. D2 gives A, C2 and C2 gives B. Shanti, move on to the next slide, please. And now we move on to the third step. We have to transform the form G dash into equivalent grammar G dash in the Grayback normal form. So we rename the variables in the ascending order form, that is V1, V2 till Vn in production P. So we take and in the form of ascending order, we rename the variables S as V1, A as V2, B as V3, C1 as V4, C2 as V5, D1 as V6 and D2 as V7. Now we see V1 gives V4, V6 or A, V6 gives V3, V4, V4 gives A, V2 gives V4, V6 or A, V3 gives V5, V7 or B, B7 gives B2, B5, and B5 gives B. Shanti, move on to the next step, please. Now we order the production in the form of ascending order. So we see V1 gives V4, V6 or A, V2 gives V4, V6 or A, B3 gives V5, V7 or B, B4 gives A, B5 gives B, B6 gives V3, V4 and V7 gives V2, V5. So now we check the rules for every step so that we see I is always less than J. So in the first, V1 gives V4, V6 or A, we see that 1 is less than 4, so this one is perfect. And then in the next one, V2 gives V4, V6 or A, here we also see 2 is less than 4, so this one is also perfect. V3 gives V5, V7 or B, here we also see 3 is less than 5, so this one is also perfect. And V4, that is non-terminal, goes to single terminal A, so this one is also done. And in the same way, V5, which is non-terminal, goes to terminal B, which is also done. And now we come to V6, which gives V3, V4. Here we see that V6 is greater than V3, that is, I is greater than J, which is not possible in Grayback normal form. So this, we have to substitute this also, and we check for V7 also in the same way. V7 gives V2, V5, and again we see I is greater than J. So this is also not Grayback normal form. So we see that rules for V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 are perfect, but we need to substitute or modify it for V6 and V7. So we modify V6 by the rule V6 gives V3, V4 and substitute the production of V3 in V6. So V6 gives V5, V7, V4 or V4. So again we check that I is less than J or not. So here we again see I is greater than, that is 6 is greater than 5. So again we need to substitute production of V5 in modified V6. So we get V6 gives B, V7, V4 or B, V4, final V6. So here we see non-terminal V6 is going into terminal B. So here we no need to check whether I is less than J or not. So this one is done. And now we move on to the next slide. Then in this, we modify V7 rule so that I is less than J. So we substitute production of V2 and V7 rule. So V7 gives V4, V6, V5 or A, V5. And again, we see I is greater than J, which is also not a proper GNF. So we need to again substitute the production so that we get at least get I is less than J or it goes into a non-terminal, in a terminal variable. So we substitute production of V4 in modified V7 rule that we get V7 goes A to A, V6, V5 or A and V5. So final, by final V7 rule, so we get we don't need to check I is less than J because the first variable in the right hand side is a terminal variable. So this is also perfect. So after substituting, we achieve the final Grayback normal form, that is V1 gives V4, V6 or A, V2 gives V4, V6 or A, V3 gives V5, V7 or B, V4 gives A, V5 gives B, V6 gives B, V7, V4 or B, V4 and V7 gives A, V6, V5 or AV. Now we get that all the V1 to V7 are in the Grayback normal form. I give my mic to Shanti.
Okay, now we'd like to conclude by saying that every context-free grammar can be transformed into an equivalent grammar in Grayback normal form. Various constructions exist. Some do not permit the second form of rule and cannot transform context-free grammars that can generate the empty word. For one such construction, the size of the constructed grammar is order of n to the power 4 in the general case and order of n to the power 3 in no derivation of the original grammar consists. In no derivation of the original grammar consists of a single non-terminal symbol where n is the size of the original grammar. This conversion can be used to prove that every context-free language can be accepted by a real-time, non-deterministic push-down automation. That is, the automation reads a letter from its input every step. Thank you.
Thank you, Shubham and Shayantini. One or two more questions that you know that context-free grammar, the upper limit by the CYK algorithm is O n cube, but why you got the O n 4, that please check, because it has been proven by any context-free grammar, it can be done O n cube. But in any case, in compiler construction, you know follow my videos, but actually we will do it in O n. Because in regular languages, it can be parsed in O(n), and your programming languages must be a deterministic context-free language. Not only that, it should be unambiguous, and there also you can make it a Chomsky's normal form or Grayback normal form. And you know the Grayback normal form, it can be parsed in n steps, and if it is Chomsky's normal form, it is 2n minus 1 step. And in Grayback normal form is one way. Another option is S grammar, that is simple grammar. That means every rule starts with a new symbol, new terminal. So from S grammar, looking at the starting symbol, you know which rule to fire. So that will definitely give O(n) times, no backtracking in that top down parser. So I think this anyway, your presentation is excellent, fantastic.
Thank you.